Good morning, gents.
Morning,
Sean.
Mate.
Paul, you well? Yep. Sean Paul.
Sean Paul.
Yeah, better than being there.
But bye bye.
Sean, rock stars.
Sean Paul. I'm going to go like B&M, MB.
How did I never make that connection before?
We were talking about the
collaboration between the two of you.
We've been thinking about a duo team name.
Sean Paul.
Yeah. Bye bye.
Sponsored by Dunkin' Donuts this morning.
I don't know what it was. Just you know what, it was a one-off, right? It was a one-off. We met up for a coffee before we came in to have a little chat. I said, "Let's go to Costa," and Masha said, "Let's go to Dunkin' Donuts."
Because he's a man of impeccable taste.
Well, do you know? Because you see it when sometimes I've gone to the toilet and you see it and you're like, oh, to go in there and just get a donut.
By the way, the toilets are next to Dunkin' Donuts in St. John's. That's what you mean.
Yeah.
Should have seen them in the shop.
It's always on your mind, isn't it? So
take us through, which ones have you chosen?
I don't know, because he was saying all kinds. He was like, you know when normally you go into a shop and you see donuts and you go, I'll have that one, I'll have that one, I'll have that one. Not him. He went, oh, look at that. I'll have an apple crumble. And then I'll have a creme brulee.
A caramel creme brulee. Saying the word, as you do. Yeah.
So you're quite particular. Anyway, you're clearly not in fight week with your Dunkin' Donuts.
Like a kid in a candy shop, lad.
There's one for you.
We'll
have it later.
We got the Headmaster one. He's our dears. Yeah. But you said you'd.
Producer John.
I want you to eat it now so I can see what's inside. And, you know.
See how excited it is. It's a donut.
Get pleasure out of someone else eating a Dunkin'
Donut.
Just
so I know next time when I get one, whether to get that one or get a different one.
Do you know what he said? This is not, I'm not lying, right? Do you know when we sat down before, he went, somebody said, oh, I'll have one of them. And he went, okay, but you can't have that one. You can't have that one.
Remember as a kid, if you'd offer some sweets to someone, but you can't have those.
Or they'd hold the bag so you couldn't put your hand in.
There's another fella coming in and I said, do you want a donut? He goes, oh, yeah. I said, get a knife then and we'll cut it in half for you.
So we'll just cut the edge off. The smaller half.
So it was an exciting morning.
You can taste it.
Nice to see you, boys. I'm looking at this picture of Tyson Fury in the papers this morning.
I think he looks great.
I said this to David Sanderson before. David said, oh, no, he still didn't think he looked like a fighter. But I think he looks like the shape he was in when he fought Klitschko, doesn't he?
Yeah. He looks well,
Some people can't naturally turn into Arnold Schwarzenegger, can they?
He looks well for the beach.
That just wouldn't be him, would it?
No. He's obviously got a bit of fake tan on there, and he's got the skimpy Y fronts, the coloureds.
There'd be Bermuda shorts on me.
He'd be a bit saggy on you. But he looks in brilliant shape, considering that was him a year ago. We're looking at the other picture, which was quite a flabby Tyson
Fury. What's he got left 2 weeks? Fighting in 2 weeks,
isn't he? June the 9th. So a bit more than 2 weeks.
Yeah.
June the 9th in Manchester. So presumably in his head, he thinks he's virtually on the road to getting back to where he was
even
at.
Even without that picture there, you know, looking at him, what is it? Comparing. He looks well.
Who's his opponent? Not sure, to be honest. Let me just Google
that. Has it popped up yet?
No. Good job that way in a question.
Good old Google.
He'd have had to gone through some serious training camps, wouldn't he?
I don't think he's got one yet.
A lot of it will obviously, it's his diet, isn't it? And it's his lifestyle, you know, he's probably been got used to just eating. There, looks like he's been eating live animals, never mind just meals.
he's been
pulling legs off.
Hasn't he been with Billy Saunders?
He has. He's been Adam Booth.
Opponent yet to be named by Frank Warren. So it says here, Fury been training hard and showing off his new physique with his colourful.
It's going to be one of them, isn't it? Let's have it right. It's going to be someone. He's going to pop in. He's going to jab him. The fella's going to fall over. He's going to get paid. We're all going to be excited over Tyson Fury all over again, and that's that.
And then everyone wants to see Fury against AJ.
That's it.
Yeah, that's how it sets itself up.
That's obviously going to be the setup. He said next year, didn't he, AJ? Didn't he say that's what he's expecting next year?
Sounds good.
That is the British fight. But let's go back to another British fight from last weekend, which was our mate Tony Bellew.
What a guy.
Against
What did
David
I tell
Hay.
You? What did I say? Now listen, I said exactly what happened.
Both looking blankly at him.
Do you not remember? Before the fight, I told you both exactly what had happened. I said exactly what was going to happen, and he did it. Good old Tony didn't let me down.
What did you say?
Can't remember.
I said
he'd win. I also said that David Day would look for an excuse. And if you'd ask me, he was dragging that leg again. And there was nothing wrong with his leg, but he started dragging it slowly, looking at it again as if to say, oh.
You think he was acting?
Look, I'm not being funny. Apparently, he's been training camp there for how many weeks, saying he's in the best tip-top shape of his life. All of a sudden,
Steve's.
It's not me. Turn your phone off. Best shape of his life, and
so he's in the best
shape
of his life. Then all of a sudden, he gets in the ring, he gets a crack, he goes down, and the legs hurting again.
There was reports of him. I think his legs were just jellied. There was reports of him going to Germany, when it's to see a specialist and stuff like that. But you always hear that, don't you? And apparently, he said something to Eddie Hearn straight after the fight, and it was. There was an article to say, you know, read up what he'd said, but
I didn't read it. I
thought you've been beat.
Or something, wasn't it?
Probably, yeah. So
does age dictate the final curtain for a boxer, or is it how they feel?
Lifestyle, isn't it?
Well, he's 38 years old, but his lifestyle would suggest he looks great.
Yeah, but it's like can look great in such a short time, but it's what he's been doing in between.
Got to look at Tony and Dave. This is a perfect example about looking and feeling great. I always say this to clientele with personal training. Vanity is one thing, but how you feel on the inside is another. Tony Bellew, because everybody looks at him and goes, oh, he's just some fat scouser. So what they don't realise is because his body doesn't develop the same way David A's genes does in a superficial way.
Yeah.
Inside, he's a tank. He's a machine. The way his body works inside is absolutely fantastic. So you're writing him off by looking at him because we live in a world of vanity. When clearly, mate, he could have went the whole show again.
Yeah, and he's always trained, so his body is it's his tendons and his ligaments are all conditioned and they're strong. Whereas David Haye lives that, you know, celebrity lifestyle and the Marbella lifestyle and then obviously when he goes start saying hard, his ligaments and tendons are snapping and, you know, becoming damaged.
It becomes tougher. It's 38 old. For a boxer to be thinking they can still be the world champ.
Now, look at Fingo. He was 50, weren't he? Still fighting George Foreman, weren't he?
I think it depends on the person. Again, he'll probably be the first person to admit that before he started training for the Tony Bellew fight, he did let himself go a lot, didn't he? He did have a party lifestyle.
But you know what? This day and age as well, probably the last, say, 5 to 10 years, the science behind everything now, that's quite relatively young. Let's be fair.
Well, Tony Bellew's 35, isn't he?
Yeah.
So David Haye's 38, and Haye hasn't said, I'm finishing yet. And Tony, by the same means, he's being questioned, are you having another fight?
He wants Andre Ward, doesn't he?
Well, he does. I don't think his wife wants him to have Andre Ward.
No.
And you know what I was saying only recently? We were talking about it last night on the Combat Hour about Tony and his missus, wasn't we? We were talking about how fantastically respectful he is of her. Or... He's scared of her.
Or both.
Yeah, but you know what, right, fair play to him. He does, he runs everything past her and she gives him whatever.
And then he butters her up and says, can I have another fight?
Yeah.
They both have a chat and then they realise that anyway, only happens anyway.
And then sends her away and she goes jogging. Yeah. Off she goes. So it works for them. You know, he respects it and... She understands that it's his job and it's giving them a lifestyle.
So you two, in Tony's mind, do you stop now or not?
No.
But how far do you go?
He's at his best, mate.
How far do you go past this point? Technically, he looks better than he ever has done.
For me, that was the best fight I've ever saw him actually turn up and fighting. And you know what? For me, I'd just say, go and do whatever you want to do. Go and take on whoever you want to take on, because no matter who he says, he's always going to get the exact same thing as he's had previously. You're going to get beat. And it consistently happens to him.
Yeah.
Going to get beat. He wins. Going to get beat. He wins.
Yeah, but he's not a heavyweight, is he? He's not going to fight AJ. He's not going to fight.
Say he was cruiserweight. He could cut down if he wanted.
Well, actually, he's got. He needs his own weight division because he's not the same as a Tyson Fury or an Anthony Joshua, and he looks too big to be a cruiserweight. So it's almost like there isn't a catchment sort of fits Tony Bellew.
He'll fight any weight, won't he?
But Steve, this is what I like about him, and this is why people can, as a fighter and as a supporter of fighting, I love any man that will just get in the ring and fight you. And this man, he doesn't come up with an excuse. I mean, bearing in mind, he's had one of the toughest years of his life because he lost his brother-in-law. And he still went into one of the biggest fights of his life and turned the style on that he had to. Which is one of the hardest things in the world to do, it really is. I mean...
At that highest level as well.
Because you're seeing the emotions pour out of him the second it ended, which showed the world who he was personally, rather than the showman that he has to
and
be.
And you never see him personally, do you? He's a showman, and you never hear of any personal stuff with him, ever. And, you know, we actually seen him on a personal basis, and it was moving.
Yeah, it all poured out then. So, so answer the question then, going back to it, who'd you fight? Is it about titles anymore or not?
No, it's about, for me, for him, personally, it's about securing his family.
But they're secure. He's got enough money.
That depends, doesn't it? It depends on your aspect of security.
I think he can now make a real name for himself, you know what I mean?
He has to, hasn't he?
Yeah, I know, but he's...
Is he Liverpool's greatest ever boxer?
Him and John Conte, yeah.
Yeah, well, as far as I know, yeah. As you know, what I know, boxing.
John Conte, really.
Well, yeah, in our era, we have to say Tony, because you know, I'm the same, I don't remember all the great things that John Conte done. I just listen to my father, but then on the other hand, a lot of people just don't want to say him. So for me, I'm gonna say, yeah, he is, he's the best boxer that's ever came out of Liverpool for me.
I'm more, you know what I mean, like not just Liverpool, but more of even the UK. You know, he's up there with the best because of what he's done. You know,
but it's still not over, Steve. I mean, he could shock again. He repeatedly shocks, doesn't he? And that's the good thing about him. He repeatedly comes up with something else and just throws it in your face and goes, yeah, I have that. What's next? Go on, I'll take that too. I mean,
like you said, he is secure with the family and stuff like that. Now, he should be anyway. But now it's like he's beating these great people where he shouldn't be winning. And there's a potential of him fighting Andre Ward, you know, a real legend. Now he can really put his name up there, you know, and...
Steve, no, there is no great paydays. There is no great paydays in cruiserweight, is there?
No.
There's no massive paydays for a title as cruiserweight.
I mean, will Andre Ward, what will he fight that day? It's probably going to be heavyweight, isn't it?
Or a catchweight, I don't know. It's something you'd have to work out.
What is the weight? Is it light, heavy, then cruiser, and then heavy?
Heavy.
Probably cruiser, won't it?
But I suppose it's have to be. But as I say, I think he just wants the big fights, the big names, because... As I was saying, cruiserweight, there's not really a massive payday there for him.
Yeah.
And it's not a massive big name for
him. But Andre Ward is a payday, given the fact that he retired and this will be his comeback. Yeah. And obviously he's a household name.
Unbeaten as well.
Yeah.
Retired unbeaten. So.
And he's a bit like Tony as well. He's starring Creed. They've both got a bit of that film star-esque bit to them.
Well, fair play to him, because he's shouting out to people you would not expect him to want to fight.
Mm-hmm. He's a clever man. There's a method behind his madness.
Well, there is. But, I mean, he wouldn't shout out at Tyson Fury, would he?
Look,
no, he's not stupid.
He's not daft, but in the position he's in, just do you know what, mate? Just go to the clouds and see what
he can do.
He's
being sensible about it.
Look, I don't like this, Steve. Win or lose his next fight, doesn't matter. For me, and it doesn't matter for anybody who knows boxing.
Ah, but it probably matters to him.
It will to him, by all means. But what I mean is he's defeated the odds, and his next fight he's going to have to go against the odds again. I think he's just going to keep ploughing through with nothing to lose. Crack on, see how far he can go.
And, of course, Tranmere Rovers heading to Wembley this weekend. 15,000, they reckon, are going to be going from Birkenhead and beyond down to Wembley this weekend, including our very own Sean Mashadot. You excited?
Yeah, I can't wait.
Yeah?
Come on, the white.
What's the capacity of Wembley?
About 90,000.
How many are going?
It's not bad. I think 15,000 is okay.
That's good, that.
Boreham Wood, who you're playing, have... is there a weekly attendance of about 600 or something?
Yeah, that's what I mean. We're massive, you know.
What are you laughing about?
Yeah.
I think, hey.
We hold.
The population of the Whittle.
Hats off. Massive occasion for Tranmere Rovers.
Fair play. Happening this weekend.
Paul's going as well, anyway.
I'm part of the show.
Did you say you played at Wembley last week?
I played at Fenton Park.
Oh, right.
See?
I played at Fenton Park.
Ripped a bit of grass and put it in his pocket and he's talking about it.
Beckenhead, this is Liverpool.
It's boxing's Battle of the Mersey.
Right, on your best behaviour, you two. Let's get into Battle of the Mersey. Currently, it's Sean Mashadod, 8.
Let's forget that.
Paul Bentley, 1. Sean Paul, 9, collectively.
So,
where do we start?
Mugs away.
Now, look, if I win... Yeah. He promised he'd sing
an outside
Sweet
shot,
Caroline.
Now, isn't it?
Oh, well, it is now, yeah. But if I win, he promised he'd sing Neil Diamond live, Sweet Caroline.
Is this true?
Tell the truth.
I didn't say it, but you know me. I don't back down from that.
You promised me last night.
I'll give it a go.
I'll have to find the words for it.
Don't find it.
Right, let's get going then. First question, and it goes to Paul Bentley. Who has said they are willing to fight on the same bill as Kell Brook in September?
Amir Khan.
Franceschi! Dan!
Good answer, that.
Sweet Caroline.
Oh, no. Wait, there. Hang on. I'm missing something here.
Why? You only got one question right.
Oh, yeah. What do you mean you're missing something?
I know, but it's
just
a good start, isn't it?
Yeah,
you know. No, but I mean, you got one right, so I'm
hang
set
on a minute, what
I'll
do you mean?
Set up.
I got one right. I get loads right. You just robbed
you
me all the time.
You just ordered something last night, and then you've set me up to sing, aren't you?
Not a chance.
No.
You'll notice in most of Masha's fights, he doesn't mind losing the first round.
Okay.
Yeah,
he's just gauging the opponent.
Yeah.
Right, Masha, whose father and trainer said he's... I'll start again. Whose father and trainer said his son is an uncrowned world champion this week? Whose father and trainer said his son is an uncrowned world champion this week?
Are you back?
Can I get passed over if you get it wrong?
The way you turned up yesterday, you
was it Nigel and Conor Benn?
Huey Fury.
Oh, him.
Huey
Fury. Dad. Peter Fury. Right, let's move on. Who is this?
Why is that his
voice?
Dad?
Don't start.
What is his uncle?
Don't start.
They're all cousins.
He's looking all quizzical. They're all connected. Who's this mystery voice? Oh, I've got them back to front. Hang on, let me change these. One, two, three. I'm just having to alter our voices.
I know what you're altering here.
Right, here we go. Who's this mystery voice?
It's fantastic. Brilliant format. Right. It's fantastic. Brilliant format.
One more time, Paul Bentley.
It's fantastic. Brilliant format.
Can we get a clue?
Flip the neck. You'd be very rich if you got this right.
Bill Gates. He sounded like my English teacher, you know.
It was Chris Tarrant. Who wants to be a millionaire?
He's not even on. Who wants to be a millionaire? Yeah, don't forget it's Piers Morgan or the other fella that he shared last week.
I can't remember.
All right. Mystery voice for you, Sean.
Yeah, wait there. I'm thinking about the other question last week.
You're trying to clear your mind.
Go ahead.
Here we go. Right, you're 1-0 down at the moment.
Quite good, actually.
Oh, gosh, that was a short one. But you should know it.
Of course he knows it.
Hang on, you've just
spoken over it. Jeremy Clarkson.
Oh, we are.
What? Sorry, what did you say?
Jeremy Clarkson.
Yeah, it's an incredible.
Yeah. Whatever. I'm not you just put him in my head. He put him in my head and then I struck him out.
Helped him out there.
Not impressed.
Yeah, right, it's our true or false round. Paul Bentley, true or false, goldfish only have a memory of 3 seconds.
True. It's true, because Nemo needed to be found and he couldn't find himself. That's why they called him Finding Nemo.
So I don't even know what you're talking about.
How many?
False. They actually remember things for quite a long time.
Really? Is that true? So they don't float round the bowl and forget they've done it?
Have a look on Wikipedia.
Oh,
so they really live a bad life. I've always thought for years that these goldfish are sound because they think they're travelling forever and ever.
No. More than 3 seconds.
In an ocean.
I'm going to have to get rid of the baby's fish. It's
a good one.
It's animal cruelty.
Eat it.
True or false? Sean, humans can distinguish between over a trillion different smells.
Is trillion a real number, though?
Humans. Did you just ask me whether a trillion was a real number?
Yeah.
You can't. You know what?
I'll go for truth. Oh, it's
spitting. Waking up, baby!
Honest to God. God.
Normo's getting.
Did you really not know if a trillion was a number?
I just think, people say trillion, zillion. Is zillion
is a zillion a number?
Trillion, zillion.
I'm sure it is somewhere.
I'm foaming here from the mouth.
Paul.
It's because of them donuts.
What's cause it?
Don't bother. You know what?
It's 2-1 to you.
Yeah.
Only because I've allegedly thought a goldfish was fine. No, it's animal cruelty.
Ian Botham, who was born in Heswell, where the Tesco is now. Ian Botham made 11 appearances in the Football League for which football club?
Are you really that serious, mate? Honestly. Tranmere. That's all I can think of.
If Steve carries on like this, he'll be evicted. Don't be like Steve.
I said that as I was saying. Wait, there might be right there.
Hang on a minute. Ian Bolton was a cricketer.
Liverpool.
Yeah, very famous one. Scunthorpe.
Oh.
Was the answer.
Yeah. Do you know what, mate? You know when I was looking up football, the last thing I thought of was Ian Bolton and Scunthorpe.
You can win at this stage. All right, you ready?
Oh, my God. It just never happens, does it?
In the May 2018 squash rankings, squash, the sport, yeah?
the orange juice
rankings. Squash. 7 out of the top 10 male players in the world came from which country?
I'm going with a wild one. Switzerland or Sweden?
Well,
in the head.
Say two.
Think of your mate who you met at Liverpool.
Why don't I ever get
Egypt?
Hang on a minute. Why don't
Dubai?
I ever get...
What's your answer? I can only give you...
Switzerland, Sweden, Egypt and Dubai.
Egypt. Yeah!
Will you behave yourself, Jonathan?
Yes!
John!
You got help. Yes!
John! Come on, lad!
Yes!
Oh, no way.
I didn't tell him the answer.
I want to speak to the gaffer.
I didn't tell him the answer.
What was the answer?
He had 4 answers.
Egypt.
See, he didn't know the answer.
I thought he said he didn't tell me.
He said Switzerland.
I didn't know I'd been corrected.
United Arab Emirates.
Calm down, you.
No, what he had in my head was
Sweegypt.
What's it?
Sweegypt.
No, so it was Mo Swalla.
It's funny how as soon as I said think of your mate at Liverpool, all you can think is Mo Salah straight away.
In fact,
stop shouting.
While we're here now, it's really important that we address the situation that goldfish are stuck in a bowl.
No, this is true. We've done our research on this. They can remember things for longer than 3 seconds.
So when we're talking
about how long?
Animal cruelty and all this, then the goldfish need to be looked after because they're stuck in bowls, aren't they?
So our kids don't want them to win one at the weekend. I was like, no.
Absolutely.
It's not fair. There's no more Steve.
Another win for Sean. Sean Paul, congratulations, boys.
Steve, you've got to help me out. I'm having people heckle me on the streets.
9-1, mate.
I've got people shouting stuff on the streets.
You're nearly on double figures. He's nearly on 2 and you're nearly on double figures.
We're flying.
Very good. Battle of the Mersey returns next week.
This is not fair no more. Thank